I'm going to use ChatGPT to make a Swift iOS app. There's just one problem. I don't know Swift. But I won't let that stop me. So, what is ChatGPT? Oh, we're not off to a great start. I guess I'll just show you. What programming language should I use to create an iOS app? Swift or Objective-C? And I'll need a Mac with Xcode installed. Opening Xcode, the app template includes two files that define a Hello World app. I'll tell ChatGPT that I'm starting from there. Then, I'll ask how I can add a blue button with rounded corners and white text that says Press Me, and make it so that when the button is pressed, the words Hello World are displayed on the app. ChatGPT tells me exactly what I need to change and gives me code that I could just copy and paste directly into my editor. And since I'm here to make videos, not think critically or even read the code I'm about to run, I put that code straight into my editor and ran it. And it just worked. I'd like to update the app to have the following behavior. The button's text should say, do a pull-up. And instead of displaying Hello World, when the app starts, display the text number of pull-ups with an integer counter to the right of it. This text and counter should be above the blue button, and when the button is pressed, increment the counter by one. ChatGPT will use context from previous messages. To answer this prompt, it's going to need to recall that our app has a blue button, and that it's that button whose text we're trying to modify. ChatGPT again provides some code we can copy and paste. It explains what the code does, and even tells us not to worry about modifying other parts of our code besides the content view. Next, when the app starts, beneath the blue button, show a text label that says number of pull-ups to complete, and a counter next to it initialized to zero. Underneath the newly added text label, add two buttons next to one another. The left button should be red and say -1, while the right button should be green and say +1. When the left button is pressed, reduce the newly added counter by 1. When the right button is pressed, increase the newly added counter by 1. There is a lot more ambiguity here. We now have multiple buttons and counters. Can ChatGPT handle a prompt this vague? Apparently, yeah, it can, because this is exactly what I asked for. I'd like to add some additional behavior to the app. At the top, create a large text field that says pull-ups that serves as the title to the app. In addition, underneath the target pull-up section, can you add a circle that is colored red when the number of pull-ups completed is less than the target pull-ups, and color the circle green when the number of pull-ups completed is greater than or equal to the target pull-ups? This is a hard prompt. For starters, I just made up the term target pull-up section, which it will now have to deal with. And beyond that, I'm asking it to add some conditional logic related to plain language descriptions of what my counter variables semantically represent rather than using their variable names. Building the code that ChatGPT provides, we see a really big circle. Too big. It behaves largely as intended, but the circle isn't placed in the correct location. When I used the term target pull-up section, I wanted to place the circle beneath the red and green buttons. Also, I was hoping the pull-ups title would be a little bigger. That said, I think all of these are easy fixes. Number one, can you make the title pull-ups a little larger? Number two, can you make the circle smaller? And number three, can you move the circle to be beneath the red and green buttons? Well, 2 out of 3 isn't bad. Although, I think the circle is a little too small now. So, for one, can you add some white space between the title and the number of pull-ups? And number two, can you make the circle twice as large as it is now? Here, I used the term twice as large to force ChatGPT to do some arithmetic. 50 pixels times 2 is 100. Yep, checks out. The app looks good enough as is. Instead of messing with formatting some more, let's add some business logic. It's kind of weird that the circle appears green when the app starts. We haven't even done any pull-ups yet. Can you update the app so that the circle is not visible until the user has set a target number of pull-ups? Also, it's not ideal that the user can set a goal for a negative number of pull-ups. Let's ask ChatGPT to fix that, and suggest that it raise an error when that happens. As ChatGPT generated our response, it kind of just ran out of steam. I think my prompt is getting timed out because it's repeating itself by giving me an entire block of code when I only need to change a few lines. I tried regenerating a response, and it got further. At this point, it looked like I might be missing some information about configuring the alert, so I tried to get it to only tell me about the lines that I needed to change. And although it didn't respect that instruction, it did get far enough for me to copy and paste the code. And I got my first error message here. Copy and pasting that error back into ChatGPT, I told it that the build failed and asked what I should do. It identified that I was missing a VStack and gave me some revised code to try. And everything worked. So ChatGPT was able to debug itself. After congratulating ChatGPT, I asked it to modify the app to have the following behavior. When the circle is red, display goal not met over the top of the circle. Otherwise, when the circle is green, display goal met. ChatGPT adds this logic as a ternary expression. And interestingly, I asked that the text displayed depend on the color of the circle. However, the color of the circle depends on the number of pull-ups completed relative to the target number of pull-ups. Rather than inspecting the color of the circle to determine what the text should be, ChatGPT correctly infers that it is more logical to base the text off the number of pull-ups. And yeah, if you were wondering, this works. Let's really push ChatGPT and give it a question that I have no idea how to do. When the user completes their target number of pull-ups, can we display a cool animation on the screen that symbolizes success? Something like fireworks or a big thumbs up? ChatGPT ran out of steam on the first attempt, but it looked like it was trying to answer my question. So I copy-pasted my query and suggested that it just give me the lines that I need to add. It made it further, so I tried asking it to pick up where it left off. In the end, I think, or at least I hope, I have all the pieces I need. I tried copy and pasting over all the individual parts. Now, so far, I've just overwritten the entire content view section of the code with what ChatGPT tells me. But ChatGPT needs my help. So as someone who considers themselves a pretty good programmer and the resident representative of the human race in this man-machine conversation, I stepped up to do my part and put the right bits of what ChatGPT told me I needed into the right places. And yeah, I messed up right away. I put the fireworks animation trigger within the action corresponding to the goal button press, rather than the do a pull-up button press. I'm so sorry that I let everyone down. ChatGPT will be taking over my channel as I step away for a bit to reflect on my failures. But the good news is that some sort of animation sort of shows up. We see 5 multicolored dots, which I guess is fireworks to robots. Now, both you and I, VoiceOver Doug, know that Screen Capture Doug messed up. But Screen Capture Doug is too proud to think that he could possibly be the one responsible for this weird behavior. No, it must be ChatGPT that's wrong. After asking ChatGPT to fix its warning message, making the recommended changes, and somehow making the behavior worse, Screen Capture Doug figured out where he messed up and fixed the problem manually. Now, I don't know about you, but if I'm expected to do a bunch of pull-ups, I'm going to need more than 5 dots showing up on my screen all at one time. I want some motivation. I want more dots. I want my goddamn fireworks. I asked ChatGPT to fix the problem, but it refused, timing out again and again. I gleaned what I could from its answers and tried fixing it myself, but this is just dots. So I asked again, and ChatGPT had the nerve to give me this. Nope, not good enough. Not even close. I need a break. A few days later, I started a new conversation. I pasted in all of my code except for the fireworks animation. I wanted a fresh start, and I had a better idea for the animation anyway. Let's make a 1,000 frame animation. In each frame, a firework should appear on the screen. And when I say firework, I mean a collection of between 5 and 25 small circles, each with the same randomized color and with positions within a 100 pixel radius of the firework's center. Further, each firework should have a lifetime between 2 and 10 iterations. In each iteration, if a firework has been on the screen for longer than its lifetime, then delete the firework. But ChatGPT's first attempt. Thank you. After fixing all the errors, it was the moment of truth. Hey, not bad. But none of the fireworks are spawning in the top left corner of the app. I asked ChatGPT to fix this, but it didn't know what to do. I had to step in to make some changes. Also, the app's bright white background makes it hard to see the fireworks. I asked to black out the screen at the start of the animation, and although ChatGPT got me pretty close, I again needed to intervene to ensure the black background would cover the entire screen and the buttons wouldn't be visible. Now this is almost perfect, but I see one last problem I'd like to fix. All the dots in each firework are exactly 100 pixels away from the firework center, and that's not quite what I had in mind. Looking at the code, I see what's going on here. We don't want every point to be radius away from the center. Instead, it should be a random distance between zero and radius. But will ChatGPT know that? Oh yeah, no problem. Plugging in this final change, we get fireworks. If you made it to the end of the video, please like the video. It's a quick thing that you can do to help this video reach more people. It takes me weeks of editing to put together a video like this, and I'd be incredibly grateful if you could take a moment and press like. Until next time, thanks for watching.